Hello, welcome to Celluloid Mirror. I'm your hostess, Betty St. Laveau. On this show, we talk about movies, film themes, film definitions, and actors. Today, we're doing a homage to all of my content creators who have helped me the last few years, not only with my show, but have inspired me to talk about different things besides film, and also to give them a shout out so that you too can subscribe to them if you like. Before we do my list, I'm going to go over three or four movies that I've seen in the last three or four days, sort of a little film journal. At first I didn't know whether or not I wanted to title this list The Grifters or The Triangle, because there's some love triangles here and there's also some grifting, but maybe it's just a combination of both. Maybe it should be called Grifting Love Triangles. At any rate, I'm going to start off with Scarlet Street. Edgar G. Robinson, Joan Bennett, and Dan Duryea. Now, Edgar G. Robinson plays a simple bank teller who is perceived as being a rube by Dan Duryea and Joan Bennett. Constance is her sister. They take advantage of his good-natured infatuation for Joan Bennett and take him all the way to the cleaners. Duryea is playing a heel as usual. He played a heel in Another Part of the Forest and in Little Foxes. Another one I can't remember either, but those are two Lillian Hellman tour de forces that he was in. Now, Joan and Dan make a they're two of the most despicable criminals I've ever seen in any movie. They're up there with these two that I'm going to talk about later, the pair in Dangerous Liaisons. Now, even the couple in Gun Crazy, Peggy Cummins and John Dahl, they at least had a fetish. They had a fetish for guns, but these two are just trying to take advantage of poor Edgar G. for all he's worth. Anyway, it is directed by Fritz Lang, who is one of my favorite directors, and you should check out this movie and his tour de force M with Peter Lorre. Okay, so the next sort of grifter movie I'd like to focus on is Dangerous Liaisons. John Malkovich, Glenn Close, Michelle Pfeiffer, Keanu Reeves, Uma Thurman, and Susie Kurtz, and a whole bunch of other cool characters also. What a lovely, beautiful movie. I love Mr. Malkovich. Malkovich and Close, of course, both play heels in this riveting movie. It's based on a book by Choldros de Laclos. Mr. Laclos himself shows up as a minor character in Hilary Mantel's A Place of Greater Danger. It's a great book about the French Revolution. And she views the writer of this book, Dangerous Liaisons, as a voyeur and someone who's overly concerned with other people's sex lives. Okay, that's how Choldros comes off in that book. Of course, I've never met the author. I've tried reading the book. The book was a little boring, but I was in my 20s. I think I'm going to try to read it. At any rate, this movie is about love, betrayal, treachery, and it's also about true love and the agony that comes with it. You know, the good stuff. Anyway, please check it out if you're in the mind for a costume drama. One of Close's better movies, and I want to say I was checking out Fatal Attraction today. I really loved her acting in that also. Let's see, so what's the next? Oh, all right, House of Strangers. This one is a very mysterious discovery. Saw it last week. Richard Conte and my gal there, she's a toughie. Richard Conte and Susan Hayward. Edgar G. Robinson plays the patriarch of this family that he rules with an iron fist, and Richard Conte is his favorite son. I have a feeling I'm getting Mr. Conti's first name a little mangled there. But at any rate, great, great movie. Susan Heywood has some of the best lines. I really enjoyed watching it. I caught it on Noir Thursday. I think it's TMC channel. All right, so we did House of Strangers. Talked about Fatal Attraction for a minute. We did Scarlet Street. What's the next one? Okay, I'm going to do the vile one for last. Rewatched Whatever Happened to Auntie Rue for a hot minute today. That's one of those grand Guggenheim movies. Whatever Happened to Baby Jane, Hush, Hush, Sweet Charlotte, and this is What Happened to Auntie Rue. This one has Geraldine Page, Mildred Dunnock, that scene stealer, Ruth Gordon, and the most excellently handsome Robert Fuller in this thriller set in the Arizona desert. I'm pretty sure it's Arizona. So Geraldine Page plays this murdering widow who bumps off for help, and Ruth Gordon plays her new housemaid who wants to bust her ass. She knows that Geraldine Page is a grifting villain, okay? So I find Ruth Gordon formidable. She'd steal a scene from a plate of turkey. I'm sorry. When she's sitting still, she's moving around. Sort of reminds me of me. I kind of jump around like that too. She's hyperactive, but she knows how to steal a scene. I think she's a great actress, but you're going to catch her mugging on your watch, believe me. She can steal a scene, all right? So I like that movie because Geraldine Page is an Oscar winner. She's an Oscar winner for Trip to Bountiful. And I believe Ms. Gordon won it, or at least got nominated for her role in Rosemary's Baby as Best Supporting Actress. Okay, so the last movie on my list, it is the most vilest, despicable. They couldn't make it in this day and age. They'd burn the mother to the ground. They'd burn Sue to the ground. And that's that wretched, vile The Babysitter with Alicia Silverstone. I like Miss Silverstone. I've bought her makeup brushes. I don't mind her one bit. I think that she's a competent actress. She scared me to death in The Crush. She snacked on Carrie Ulls like there was no tomorrow. She's an extremely competent actress. In this movie, she's perved on by J.T. Walsh, Jeremy London, Michael Catt, and who else is perving on her? I think that that's it. George Segal and Lois Chow are slumming to boot. She plays a babysitter who the man she babysits for is fantasizing on her. Nicky Catt, who he was in The Limey. He played a dingbat a bandit in The Limey. Nicky Catt is this guy she doesn't like, and Jeremy London is the guy that she likes, but whatever, she's trying to keep at a distance. Anyway, it gets confusing because they all start having fantasies about her in their heads and stuff like that. And it was just horrifying, horrific. I don't know why I stuck with it. I thought I was going to sort of see something like, oh, I don't know, The Hand That Rocks the Cradle. I mean, that Keith Carradine movie with Daryl Hannah, where they're trying to get their child back. I thought it was going to be like that. I also thought it was going to be like that that Rebecca De Mornay movie, but it was totally taking advantage of Ms. Silverstone's position as an innocent ingenue in Hollywood. Anyway, good job, Alicia. I think you did great. Now, and my respect to the cast, too, and to the crew, but This movie, I kept fast-forwarding through it. Don't catch it tonight, all right? So I think that's it for my grifting love triangle movies. The love triangle and What Happened to Aunt Rue, there's not really a love triangle here, but it's more how Geraldine's a grifter. Scarlet Street, it's definitely a love triangle, and the grifters. And The Babysitter, a lot of imaginary love triangles. In House of Strangers, Grifting, no love triangle. Fatal attraction, love triangle. Dangerous liaisons, grifting, and love triangle. All right, so maybe I'll do a complete show on that one day. Anyway, movies of the week, everybody. All right, so now we're going to get on to the content creators who I wish I knew and who I love a lot. Some of them are content creators who have encouraged me to do my thing on my show. There's not a lot of them. Some of these content creators are, I look up to them, they're my mentors. And then quite a few of them have given me a little heart comment and told me, thank you for looking at the show. And then some I just like, so let's get on with the list. Starting at number one, and he should be and could be number one for so many reasons, but basically this list is in alphabetical order, is Alpaca Thesaurus. He is one of my most sublime senseis. He does MMA and UFC news with an emphasis on psychological analysis and technical breakdown of fights, press conferences, face-off, and stares. I did not get his subscription number, but I think that it's in the many thousands. I had to go back and look at everyone's number, so maybe next week I can give you some information on that. The next one is A.M. Glimpse. Great true crime documentaries. His motto is a glimpse into the strange and scandalous. And right there, I don't have any numbers for that. Aras Crime has 171 subs. They analyze crime. Beige Frequency, who frequently gives topics on topics on the state of comedy in America today and some other things. He has 151 subs. Beyond Evil is one of my very favorite true crime peeps. They have 151 subs, and their slogan is captivating true crime narratives. Beyond Evil, captivating true crime narratives with eyes on the victim's stories. That particular show has 151 subs. Their podcast has 783,000 subs. Body Cam Watch and Cold Blue Cam, they were my first, and they're like resisting arrest. I'll just mention all three of them together. They're some of my first arrest videos where you watch people act up on planes and drunken bars and stuff like that. And I know that that sounds so lowbrow, but it's good for me to see what the peeps are doing outside Vermont. You know what I mean? Some people, the way that they cuss and swear at cops. So those shows are, I watch those to delve into that. Body Cam Watch, I didn't write down the subs for that, but Cold Blue Cam has 2.1 million viewers, subs. And it's their slogan is unbiased, genuine footage. Please check them out. Okay, so we have Brian Stutterer, MD, 750,000 subs. He explains about sports injuries. Briefcase and crime, briefcase and my, what's my, oh, my other, they're both my twin crime library peeps that I discovered about 4 or 5 years ago. They do old crime tales that people have forgotten about or don't know too much about. Briefcase has 407,000 subs, historical and forgotten criminal cases. The Cartier family, they have 135 subs. They're a bunch of good-looking guys who just roasted the Fourth Republican debate. And I don't know their names. I've only seen their show once or twice, but you'll be hearing more about them from me. I really like them a lot. They have some good humor as they were doing a reaction video to the debate there. Now, Case File Presents, they have 86.4 subscribers. I fall asleep to Case Files because this gentleman has this Australian accent. It's very soothing, even while listening to the most upsetting crimes. My man Chael Sonnen is at 1.24 million subs. It's Chael's perspective on the world of MMA. Chael is my favorite retired fighter. Mr. Tony Ferguson is my favorite active fighter. More on Mr. Tony later. I can't wait till he retires. Okay, so then I do the Chanel ad. I do Cinema City, Cinema World, CLL Bruce Rivers with 1.8 million subs. That is my criminal lawyer reacts, and his son Michael is his director and producer. Please check him out. He reacts and comments on the big cases of the day. We have Crimespiracy, Cult Cinema Classics, Dan Hardy Full Reptile. My man does MMA commentary, and he was a fighter. Dave's Lemonade and Dave's Lemons. Dave Lemonade, he does crime documentaries, and he stands at 217 subs, and Dave's Lemons, he's at 25.6 thousand. Then we have the sublime Dead Meat, 6.2 million. That's James A. Janisse and his beautiful wife, Chelsea Rebecca. It's home of a Kill Count series, so all those scary movies you don't ever want to watch, James and Chelsea will walk you right through them, and plus they have a podcast. All right, Death Row Executions by Air is at 115,000 subs, 115,000. I really love Air quite a bit. She has a beautiful voice, and she does the death row execution list. Sometimes she has, I'm going to say it, the prettiest executed criminals. She has what they ate last, how old they were, etc. Please check her out. Then my man Derek Van Chack is at 611,000 subs. He does criminal psychology and behavioral analysis. I love content creators who do stuff like that. Dr. Romani, she's at 1.56 million. She does the same thing. My man Dr. Tom Grande, he does essays on mental health, human behavior, relationship dynamics. He's at 1.38. Dolce & Gabbana. Then we've got My Dreading Crime and Psychology. They are at 729,000 subs. They do true crime new videos every Wednesday and every other Sunday, 10 p.m. Central Standard Time. Ellie Mack is another true crime aficionado. She's at 28.3 subs. I hope her channel grows. She's really, really great. Next, we come to Iwu Crew. Iwu Crew is short for... I can't believe I can't remember what it's for. Explore with us. Explore with us. So Iru does Iru Body Cam, which has 456,000. Crime Time, 834,000. Iru Crime Vault, 434,000. And Iru History, 105,000 subs. The Iwu Crew Explore With Us, the Big Daddy, that's at 4.67 million peeps. I love Explore With Us. Most of the crime library peeps I study have great production values, and these are one of them. Okay, so I just started subbing to Geek. He's at 26.6 thousand. He does commentary on boxing and MMA. He's very good at it. God Eye Media, that's my man Edison. He's at 26.1 thousand people. Edison is very funny. If you look at God Eye a couple years ago, he was busting down on red carpet walks and music awards and stuff like that. Helen Yee Sports. Helen, I think the schmo, he also does commentary. She got him started. Helen Yee is an athlete who does interviews with mixed martial artists. I really like her. She's professional and very friendly when she interviews those MMA fighters. Next comes my History Roadshow, which explores women's history from queens to commoners, past and present, New Adventures Weekly. John Show stands at 75,000 subscribers. I really love History Roadshow. Please check out John's show. It is amazing. His production values are incredible. Okay, Hoods and Hollers at 57.8, documenting neighbors' hoods in America, one city at a time. Hoods, county no-go, holler zones, and abandoned towns. This is a very beautiful show. The camera pans slowly over deserted neighborhoods. It's quite poignant. All right, next we come to someone who is definitely one of my mentors, and that is JCS Jim Can't Swim, criminal psychology. He stands at 503,000, but the JCS criminal psychology stands at 5.49 million, that show. Forensic psychology, true crime, and social, I don't know what that last word I wrote is. Jim Can't Swim is incredible. He got taken off of YouTube for his content, which I find absolutely inane. He was posting intense videos involving true crime matters. When I see some of the caca that makes up on YouTube, and my man Jim Can't Swim isn't producing new videos, it's very annoying. All right, my man Jerry Skinner, Mississippi accent, love you, Jerry. He says, I've got a Mississippi accent, if it bothers you. Jerry, your Mississippi accent does not bother me at all. He did an excellent essay on Buford Pusser. Next we have my sensei, Ken K TV, cinematic combat, sports content, original content, boxing, MMA, family friendly. Mr. Cannon actually has watched my show. He thought it was good. He has helped me so much with learning about MMA. He and Alpaca were so kind to me in the beginning, encouraging me and continuing to be a fan. And Mind Smash, very encouraging too, but Ken and Kay and Alpaca, thank you so much for all of your help. Now, mysteriously enough, I have Lex Fridman after Ken and Kay. Lex Fridman, he comes up, when I leave the computer on at night, he comes up in my algorithm. He's at 3.5 million subscribers. He's a neurophysicist, but also a martial artist. He's very intelligent. He has everybody on his show. Live Abuse Free is at 140,000 subs. This lovely lady talks about cluster B personality disorders, abusive behavior, and healing. She was my first psychologist, I think, that I discovered on YouTube. Next, we come to LPR Presents. I can't believe he's only at 17.2 thousand subscribers. This is a true crime docuseries that aims to be curated and complete, focusing on the people aspect as much as the crime. Again, excellent content values. I'm a total fan. Lucas Tracy MMA is one of my newest MMA mentors. He's at 58.1 thousand subscribers. No walking on eggshells, no beating around the bush, nothing but the truth. I love you, Lucas. He's very passionate. And so is my MMA Joey. We'll come to him later. Both of them, they'll tell it like it is when it comes to MMA. Martin Decoder, Seeking Truth Through Language. I really like Mr. Decoder a bit. He's at 158,000. Matt Orchard, Crime and Society. I don't have the numbers for him, but he kind of took over where JCS has left off. He did a great documentary on the Jerry Michael Williams case, Denise Williams, his wife, and Brian Chichester, his best friend. They both got rid of Mr. Williams. Anyway, Mr. Orchard did a really, really great, fantastic essay on that. Please check that out. Memer the Lemur. I subscribe to Memer the Lemur because they are a cat rescuer, and I'm not really a cat person, but I've got a lot of cat in me. But also, I subscribe to Nemo the Lemur because we became friends via Briefcase and my other crime channel there that I hope I wrote down. Okay, so at any rate, going right through the list here. I think we're done with that. One more page to go. One more page to go. All right, so we've come to Mind Smashed, another MMA mentor. He's at 611,000 subscribers. MMA Joey, he's at 14.3 subscribers and growing. His caption is, a guy who loves MMA talking about all things MMA. Look, MMA Joey, Mr. Joey, he's incredible, and so's Lucas. They will go off. MMA Joey, he'll do a cuts list. He has different lists, reaction to this UFC fight, reaction to that. He has a cuts list. Who needs to be cut after UFC such and such? He cut Dana White one time. He's cut Joe Rogan. He has cut, I think he's cut Daniel Cormier. He's cut a couple, I don't know if he cut DC, but he cut Joe Rogan. So he's unapologetic. What a breath of fresh air. I love listening to MMA Joey. And I go to sleep to him too. Mojahed Fudulat, he does cartoons on MMA. Please check out Mojahed Fudulat. Love him. He's at 542 subscribers. Moses Prim and Prim's Hood Cinema. 41.1 for Moses Prim. I love him. Moses Prim, all the Hood movies, the black exploitation movies that you didn't want to watch, the Hood movies in the 80s, he'll walk you through them. Ms. Legistia, Attorney Sheila, North Carolina attorney, focuses on business law, entertainment, intellectual property, and social media law. She's at 5.9 subscribers. I love Attorney Sheila. She's awesome. And Nate Diaz and Nick Diaz, they're both, they're OG MMA. Nate's at 361,000 subscribers, and Nick is at 30 subscribers. I'll listen to whatever, anything the Diaz brothers have to say. We've got my man Newcastle After Dark. They have 86,000 subscribers. Movie hosts from Western Pennsylvania and Northern Ohio. Once a month, a feast for the mind, coming from Newcastle, Pennsylvania. Love them. They do all the old horror movies we watched as kids. Old Fashioned Murder and Mayhem is at 3.5 subscribers. True Crimes That Shocked Our Ancestors. Once Upon a Time podcast, hosted by Esther. The Real Story Behind the Real Crime at 10,300 subscribers. I can't believe that. I must have wrote that wrong. Esther's incredible. Okay, we're in the home stretch here. Pat Bet David and the home team. Pat Bet David's broadcast is at 1.55 million subscribers. It takes place in a vault 2 times a week. All right, the first time that I caught Pat Bet David was when Michael Francisi and Sammy the Bull Gravano, they had a sit down and they were talking about Michael Francisi's United Mafia States of America, I can't remember, Mafia States of America podcast that he was doing. Anyway, these two old, goombas, they go at it. And it went from one thing to another, and I show my sister Laura, and I show some friends, and these guys were talking about the old days, old times, about people that no one have any idea anybody's talking about. But ever since then, I like Pat Bet David. And then I caught him, Vinny, Adam, and I can't remember the other gentleman's name. And they were going off about the Rachel Zegler Disney scandal. And I got myself an education. I really like these guys. They have everybody on the show, which is good, like anybody. And I think that that's the right way it should be. You shouldn't just have one political party or another political party. You need to mix it up a little bit. So I love Pat Bet David. Please check him out. Red Tree Crime and Red Tree Stories. Red Tree Crime is at 62 626,000 and Retrie Stories at 288,000. Great narration, great production values. Now, Resisting Arrest TV, though that's one of my newest loves. It's at 19.4 subscribers, and I think that that is one of those content creators. Someone, I gave Resisting Arrest a compliment, and then someone replied to me and said that, I think it's Resisting Arrest. If I'm making a mistake, I'm so sorry, but they're saying that they're taking other info and they're taking information from other content creators and not giving them credit for it. So I'll look more into that. But I really like Resisting Arrest a lot. Southern Fried True Crime. This gal, she was a librarian for years and years and a genealogist. I can't remember her name offhand. I'm so sorry. But please check out Southern Fried True Crime. She's at 15.6 subscribers. Then here comes my man, Spooky Rice. Let's watch some crazy stuff together. That's their caption. They're at 601,000 subscribers. Spooky Rice is funny. He like James A. Janisse, does the scary stuff you don't want to see. But Spooky Rice, he goes in depth. Like he does movies like a Pier Paolo Pasolini's 12 Days of Sodom. You know, stuff like that. So tread lightly with Spooky Rice, but very entertaining. Stay Awake, Crime and Psychology, Creepy Crime, True Crime Stories, 3 videos a month. There are 260,000 subscribers. My man, Stephen Wonderboy Thompson, he's one of my MMA senseis. He trained in Kempo when he was 3 and started competing at kickboxing when he was 15. Please check out his show. He does techniques and it's extremely family friendly. His brother Sweet Tea also hosts with him sometimes. He's at 548 subscribers. And he's a welterweight. He just had a fight with, who did he just fight? Can't remember who he fought, but he didn't win. But Wonder Boy is always a winner in our hearts. All right, Steve Reviews. He's a British content creator who breaks down the scary cartoons of our childhood. Love him. He's done Plague Dogs, Watership Down, and The Creatures of Farthing Wood. He's got a lot of good humor. He's at 558,000 subscribers. Submission Radio, Made in Melbourne for the World, is Australia's premier MMA show. 228 subscribers. Now, Behavior Panel is at 158,000, and Body Language Guy, my man DeRosas, he's at 618 subscribers. Oh, I hope I pronounced your name right. They do psychology. They'll show a video of someone doing their thing talking, and then they'll comment on it. And sometimes they don't have the video, but they will comment on someone's behavior. All right. Now, Vigilant Cam, it's like a Blue Code Cam. They're at 78,000. Why the French Toast? They comment on some crazy stuff. They're at 22,000. Wicked Women, they're at 5,000.21. Surprisingly, they have more subscribers. Truly Criminal, crime show, 651,000. Travelmatic, my man travels all around South America. He's awesome. He's at 7,000, almost 8,000 subscribers. This is Monsters, another true crime show, is at 700,000. Weasel, he is the Weasel. He's at 348,000. Subscribers. He's an MMA commentator. I'm shocked that his numbers are that low. The King in Giallo is one of my newest favorites. He's at 881,000. The Trey Cray. Cray Trey, they do the last fight that happened in MMA, last big fight, and they break down the presser and they show how the guy who lost was like, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that, and then he gets his ass beat. good entertainment. Even though it sounds horrible, but it's really good. He shows the human side of the fighter, but he also shows that if you talk about anyone's mama, you're going to get your ass beat by Michael Chiesa. Like, don't talk about anyone's mama before you get in the octagon. Oh, now, the crime reel. It's so funny. Whenever I do briefcase and crime reel in my mind, crime reel is at 103,000 subscribers. The crime reel and briefcase, they are my crime library OGs. If it weren't for them, would I have gotten a true crime on YouTube? Maybe. I think so, but thank you so much. They're both British. Their shows are incredible. They aren't long enough. Sometimes they do hour specials. But again, like Briefcase, Crime Reel does old forgotten stories. Now, last but not least, on my content creator list, and thank you for your patience if you've stuck around here this long. I hope I didn't skip anyone, but by numero uno, the Crime Atlas. Crime Atlas, the production values cannot be beat. The narration is incredible. They actually had a new narrator a couple weeks ago, and people were like, we like your narration. I love the narration. I'm going to give you their caption. Fact-based true crime documentaries approaching the subject matter with objectivity and compassion. Also, we love a good intro. Okay, so these are my adored content creators. Some I love more than others, but it's not because it's not a competition. It's just I either met them first or I'm more inclined to dig them. So basically, Alpaca Thesaurus, Mind Smash, and Canon KTV, they go with me when it comes to my old school way of thinking about M&A. They got me on my path. Lucas Tracy, MMA, and MMA Joey, they're sort of part of my new way of looking at it. I thank all five of them very much. When it comes to Moses Prim, James A. Janisse and Chelsea's Dead Meat, and Spooky Rice, I thank them so much for walking me through movies that I would ordinarily have just passed by. Thanks to Primsuit Cinema, I've actually watched what's that, Wesley Snipes, of course I can't remember it, but it's got Chris Rock in it, and my man there, Ice-T, New Jack City. Because of Primsuit Cinema, I've actually watched New Jack City, so some of these content creators have really helped expand my mind when it comes to cinema. Now, I almost think that's it. When it comes to these crime content creators, I thank them so much for their hard work and their crews too, because these peeps don't do it all their own. They have a crew that assists them with everything. Yeah, Crime Atlas, Stay Awake, Red Tree Crime, Ewu Crew, incredible, incredible. Behavior Panel, Body Language Guy, Derek Von Shake and Martin Decoder, Live Abuse Free and Dr. Remini, thank you so much for helping me and all of us look at another side of where people are coming from when they're talking and gesticulating. All right? Okay, so. So, Dr. Todd Grande, please check out his essays on mental health, human behavior, and relationship dynamics. What a great doctor. Really, really good. Thank you, Ellie Mack, for starting your show. God Eye Media, Edison, for making me laugh. I'm a sub on the Dorothy Malone channel. She's got 24 subs, but she's one of my favorite actresses. Okay, so I hope that this will help you all find out some content creators that you'll learn to like and love. Until then, I'm Betty St. Laveau. I want to thank Ma Crew here for helping me out with this show today. And I want to thank everybody who's ever worked on a movie, and to maybe a Broadway production too, but anybody who has done the technical side of the art and the business. It's not for sissies. It's no joke, and it can be very fun and rewarding. Until next time, y'all take care, and a special thanks to my professor of cinema, Ochazanya Klarich, a.k.a. Sharon Audella Warfield Paris, for walking me through and taking me through the fascinating language of cinema. Until next time, Childs, y'all stay away from those bad movies. Ciao.